Welcome to Moving Forward with Uponor. I'm Daniel.
And I'm Marcus.
And we are here every Thursday to talk to you about all things Uponor, including plumbing, mechanical, and industry. So what are we going to talk about today, Marcus?
Well, today I want to talk about our Ppr Ct system, a new offering that Uponor has had here now just over a year. Before we dive into that, though, I want to talk about just briefly the history of polypropylene piping systems.
So polypropylene was first introduced back over in Europe in the 1950s. And then most recently in North America was PPR, which is polypropylene random. And then in the early 2000s-ish in North America, Ppr Ct comes along. So what does Ppr Ct stand for?
So it stands for polypropylene random cold polymer crystallinity with raised temperature.
Right. And basically, what does that mean? So what is the difference between Ppr Ct and PPR? And the real difference is it's a different resin, obviously, but it for the same SDR, let's say, you could have higher temperature and pressure resistance for a Ppr Ct pipe versus a PPR pipe.
Correct, and that's what the next evolution of this piping and joining technology. It's why Uponor had partnered with it. So it's the newest technology that's on the market in the polypropylene family with the RCT on it, and that random raised temperature crystallinity allows us to have higher temperatures at higher pressures along with having a longer lifespan as well.
Right, so it's up to a 50% increase in long-term strength with the Ppr Ct resin versus standard polypropylene resin. So like Marcus mentioned, it is the latest resin in the polypropylene family, and you're starting to see some other manufacturers as well add Ppr Ct to their lineups, which were traditionally just polypropylene random.
That's right. Now with this new Ppr Ct piping system, there's a lot of benefits to this to the contractor. Let's talk about those.
Right, so the biggest one, number one, is safety. Right, so if we're talking about Ppr Ct versus, let's say, steel, right, you're welding both of them, but they're different types of welding. So with Ppr Ct, you have fusion welding, and with steel, you have welding, where you actually have open flame, you have things like fire watch, right, that are much different than when you're fusion welding Ppr Ct, where you don't have open flame, instead you just have basically heat.
That's right, so not only is it safety, but like you kind of alluded to, it's more productivity because of the safety factor. You don't have to worry, have an extra standby on fire watch. You don't have to worry about a burn permit. You don't have to worry about setting up safety welding curtains if you're working kind of on an open job site. And there's also, so that's the labor side, but there's also the material side too, having a more consistent pricing in the market with the Ppr Ct as opposed to metallic systems.
Right, so now you're not relying on commodity pricing, right, like you would with steel and copper. Obviously, we've seen huge fluctuations in that over the last year and a half with steel and copper. So now instead, you're basically being able to bid projects confidently, knowing that your product's not gonna go up 20-30% over a 6 to 8 month time frame. Let's talk about the offering itself, right? So what does Uponor have for a Ppr Ct offering? So we offer sizes in 1/2 inch up to 12 inch. And basically we have 4 different SDRs. But the smaller SDRs, like the 7.4, is primarily in the 1/2 and 3/4 inch sizes, so you don't see that a whole lot. But what are the other basically 3 SDRs that we'll see on the pipe sizes?
So the other 3 sizes that we see, the SDRs, are SDR 9, SDR 11, and SDR 17.6. And, you know, talking about the SDR, so as opposed to the pipe size schedules and pipes, when you hear schedule 40 or schedule 80 in pipe sizes, the higher the schedule, the thicker the wall. In this instance with Ppr Ct, the higher the SDR, it's actually a thinner wall.
Right. So an SDR 17.6 is the thinnest wall versus an SDR 7.4, which is the thickest wall. So opposite cadence of schedules, but similar to how they basically are calling it out. So it's a reference to basically the pipe's wall thickness relative to the outside diameter. And then the other big thing, I don't know it's kind of hard to see with our little samples here, but all of the mechanical piping that we offer actually has a fiber layer in it as well that's extruded with the pipe. And the benefit of that is it actually helps limit expansion and contraction. So as the piping system is heating up or cooling down, depending upon what you're running through it for a fluid, it'll actually help limit that to something much more similar to like steel or copper versus like what you would think in a typical polymer piping system.
That fiber layer, that raised temperature and crystallinity, providing the ability to operate at higher temps, higher pressures with less thermal expansion.
So we talked about the pipe sizes, the SDRs. Now let's talk about fittings for a little bit. So the basically two connection methods for polypropylene to kind of dictate which fittings you're going to use. So up to 4-inch, you're typically using socket fusion. So you'd have socket fusion tees, couplings, elbows, that kind of stuff. And then for 6-inch and larger, you have butt fusion. Now, one thing that's common between both of them would be like saddle adapters, for example. So we have saddle adapters that are available with Uponor's Pprct connection on them as well. So if you want to go from PPRCT to Uponor PEX, you can easily do that. And obviously we're working on producing more of these in larger sizes, so you can go all the way up to 3-inch PEX if you really wanted to.
So those connection methods, as you said, whether it be with adapters or different tees, elbows, configuration, different fitting configurations, there's really two different methods of joining them or joining the pipe together, socket fusion and butt fusion. So with socket fusion, that's actually heating up the outside diameter of the pipe and the inside diameter of the fitting. So here's a coupling that you see here. It's actually using an iron that heats up on the inside of the fitting and the outside of the pipe at the same time. And then there's a time sequence of actually pushing them together. So when you join those and make that connection, it's nice and seamless.
Right. And then for the larger sizes, like we talked about with butt fusion, you have fittings like this, which is, this is actually a prefabricated elbow that you can buy. But if you wanted to, let's say, field make an elbow or a 45, you could do that with different sections like this. And these are all butt fused together using a tool like that McElroy Acrobat over there.
And there's different type of manufacturers for the tooling that's out there. There's McElroy that you see here on the table. All tooling manufacturers provide training certification for installation. Uponor will train on the site or bring you to our headquarters in Apple Valley, Minnesota. And we'll have our master certified trainers train the installers, train your foreman, your superintendent, the team that's doing the actual install with our PPRC team to make sure that they're certified. And that's also important because it's part of the warranty with the PPRCT system.
Right, so we're really big on training, whether it's the PEX side or the PPRCT side. And our training team's done an awesome job of getting that stuff, making the courses, getting everything available. We have McElroy master trainers on staff, as well as trainers for the WIDOS and RIPMO tools like Marcus said as well. So now let's talk a little bit about hangers quickly. So we mentioned the pipe has a metric OD, but we also talked about this conversion to iron pipe size, right? So we have a table that'll say if you have, let's say, 63 millimeter or 2-inch pipe, PPRCT, it'll tell you the equivalent iron pipe size hanger that you would need to find.
That's right, and that's important when you're insulating the pipe or finding hangers for it to really make sure that you look at that table chart, you understand what size clamps you need, and what size insulation. So there are manufacturers that produce a insulation for metric sizes, or you can also use insulation intended for iron pipe sizes as well.
Right. And then last but not least, since we're talking about insulation, Uponor does have an ASTM E84 listing that we've gotten through our third-party testing agency. So if you do run into a project that has a return air plenum, we can get you a PPRCT product that'll work for that and a listing up to 12-inch currently. And then obviously we'll be working on additional listings in the future as project requirements come up for that. All right, so we talked about a lot of cool stuff with the PPRCT system, right? Benefits to the customer, offering overviews, some stuff on hangers. Obviously, if you guys need more information on that, you can check out our manuals on our website, which is www.uponor.com. We have tons of information on there that's available. And again, if you have questions, you can email us or post comments down below in this video. And thanks again for watching.